So when it comes to cameras, I never really had a camera. Ever since I was a kid, my dad gave away the cameras that we had, and it was, I think, more of a point and shoot one, the really small ones. And I think when I was in high school, I had a CyberShot, and in between I had a disposable Kodak camera. Other than that, my dad was the first one to buy a camera, and it was a Nikon something. And I never really got to play around with it because I wasn't allowed to touch it. So in my adult life, the first ever camera that I touched was a Sony a7 III, the one that I'm recording with now, and that's a mirrorless camera. So I basically skipped over the SLR, DSLR stage and went straight to mirrorless. My friend, he's selling off his old gear, and his old gear was a Canon 60D, which came out in around 2010. So this is 2020, it's been 12 years. So he told me that I can have a play with his old gear, and I thought that, you know what, maybe I will have a go at the old DSLR stage that I missed out on. And so I thought of making this video. I've never used Canon before, so it'll be interesting in trying it out. So here I have the 60D. It is a APS-C sensor camera with a flip out screen. Ooh. And I think it has 18 megapixels. It does shoot video, I think 1080p HD. At 25 frames a second. I'm not sure about the other specs. On first impressions, it is hefty. It is thicker and bigger than the Sony a7 III. The grip is, I would say, better because it's bigger and my pinky doesn't float at the bottom and it's a bit deeper, so it's a good grip. Enough chit chat. I'm gonna go test this out. But before I do, I'm not sure which lens to try with this camera. So I have a selection here. I have a 60 millimeter macro 2.8, it's a USM. Then I have an EF 50 millimeter 1.8. And I also have a Tokina 11-16 F2.8. I also have a Canon. This is 24-105 L mount, L glass, I think L series, image stabilized USM. So, enough chit chat, we're gonna go out and test it. So let's go. It's close to sunset, so it should be all right. The sunlight is good. Then I'll, after this, maybe I'll try some nighttime photography. And 18 megapixels, I think, is fine. It's good enough for social media. So when it comes to social media, I think even 12 megapixel, like an iPhone camera, is fine. I'm still getting used to the whole EVF. Well, it's not an electronic viewfinder, it's just a viewfinder. Because what you're seeing with this is what you see in real life, because you're reflecting through a mirror inside the DSLR. But in a mirrorless camera, there's no mirror, hence the mirrorless. But that's what I'm trying to get used to. Hopefully, we'll see how it goes. So far, when it comes to daytime photography, as far as I can see, this camera is more than adequate. I would definitely recommend it in 2022 if you're doing photography as a hobby. I think you can still record. I'm not sure how the autofocus is on this. I haven't really tried. For video recording, I'm not sure. For photo photography, this is more than enough. It's plenty. So you can always get a nice lens, pair it up with this camera, and you have a nice setup for hobbyist photography.
A few moments later.
All right, so it's nighttime. So what I'm gonna do is I change the lens to a 1.8. So this is a Philips 50 millimeter 1.8 Canon lens to give it a fighting chance. Really dark, so 1.8 aperture. I'll make the shutter speed 1/80th because I think I can handle 1/80th of a second. Not too bad. I think I might have to take a bit more shots, maybe down there where it's a bit more lighter. All right, so this area is a bit more better lit. So we'll see how the images turn out here. So one thing I forgot to mention, that this camera also has flash. So if you ever find yourself in a dark room or in a dark situation, you can always whip this out and use the flash. I, however, am not a big fan of flash, especially in darker lit areas. Obviously, flash can be used in better ways, creative ways, like off-camera flash. However, on-camera flash, I rarely use it, so use at your own peril. Funny how my shoes, my shirt, and the background all matches. I think you guys can kind of guess that red is my favorite color, and black. Overall with this camera, I have found it is a bit hard to use. Not hard per se, but because I haven't figured out how to get a live view on the screen. All I can see here is the settings of what I'm shooting, and I can't really see what's being shot until it has been shot. So until after I've taken the shot, I can't know what's going on. So when I increase the shutter speed or increase the ISO, I'm not sure what the image is looking like until I take the shot and then review it. Maybe there might be a way. I did look in the settings and it did say enable live shooting, and I did. Not sure why it hasn't shown up. Overall, my thoughts with this camera are that definitely can be a contender to be used in 2022 if you are not aiming to go pro or just having photography on the side as a hobby. Definitely a good camera, a bit bulky, and I think that everyone's moving towards mirrorless. Even with that, I think having this sort of camera, you know, not to break the bank, in good quality, is still a viable option. And I think when it comes to photography, it doesn't really matter what brand you shoot with, because if you're shooting raw, you can always change the colors after the fact. And the fact that you're shooting raw, it's no big deal, because you're not really baking in the settings, so you can always change everything afterwards. Obviously, the Canon colors are there. They have their own science, and obviously Canon have more oranges in their colors, and I think Sony lacks that. But other than that, you can always finesse the colors in Lightroom and get close to what you want. For those people who are just looking to get great shots straight out of camera, then definitely, you know, Canon is a good brand, and definitely this camera will still be worth it. Obviously, there are other cameras out there like the Sony A6000 line, which are around the same price. So these go for around $400 a body, $450. And I think the A6000 also goes for around $400, $450 Australian dollars, I'm speaking. And so with that being said, I mean, if you like the smaller form factor of the A6000 cameras, definitely they're good. But if you like the Canon ecosystem and you have EF lenses, then definitely Canon is a good choice. And plus, having a bigger camera makes you look more professional. I think that's just how it is. You know, if you go to a place and you have a bigger camera on you, people already think that, you know, it's more professional. But if you want to be inconspicuous, then I think a smaller camera that fits into your pocket, like an A6000 series, are good enough. When it comes to shooting with a Canon 60D, I would say, yeah, it's definitely a good choice if you want to buy it in 2022. And if you ever want to upgrade, you can always upgrade, because they're not that expensive. Well, that is it for now. Hopefully this video was enjoyable. Hopefully you guys learned something. Hopefully I influenced your decision in something. Yeah, other than that, thank you for watching. Catch you in the next one. You know the drill. See ya.